Macintosh presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Porter has the ball set how he wants it, and we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks.
He sends this one deep, and it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
The Knights and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. When you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
First and 10, all on their own 35.
He throws it. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
He faked out everybody in the stadium. When you can sell the run that well, you're going to have the upper hand on the defense.
The 41.
A 2-yard run by the halfback.
There was simply no daylight on that play. The defender came in and dropped the hammer.
Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 41. Great concentration to pull it in. He's tackled at the 22-yard line.
From the 22-yard line, first down. Nice run to the outside.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and 5.
There's a strike complete.
The 10, and it pays off. Touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
PAT. A 6-play, 76-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 7-0.
Breedlove fields it at the 22, and down he goes at the 29-yard line.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Made at about the 37-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. They'll get him for a loss.
Well, that's just a good call from the defensive side of the football. They know what this team likes to run, and they got the better of them that time. Surge by the defense. They really disrupted the timing on that play and gave them no chance to get the first.
Burks is waiting for the snap. Oh, excellent punt. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
Gain of 5 on the play. That brings them second and 5.
Second and 5. Ball on the 25-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He goes out of bounds at the 28-yard line. Sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
And that'll be 3 and out. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. Richardson fields it at the 39. Tackle at the 45-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. He makes it to the 48-yard line. From their own 48-yard line. Second down. Great tackle at the 49-yard line.
That's good for 3 yards. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Right and left. Mark 4.
Pulls it in and gets out of bounds.
Love to watch quarterbacks on third down to just kind of see where they are as far as their psyche and their approach to the game. This is another big third down. He was able to sit back, evaluate the defense, had just enough time to be able to make the throw. We pick up the first down and get a new set of downs.
And they make the stop at the 30. First and 10. Ball on the 30. McKeon picks up a yard on the play. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle at the 28. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 7-0, Knights. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
You can bend a bit as a defense, but when they're this deep in your own territory, you just can't break.
So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he just drilled it from long range. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. The 50. He gets hit out of bounds.
At about the 39-yard line.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Tackle after decent pickup.
That's how we do, Dean. That's how we do. They don't
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Loss of one there for the halfback. Taken down at about the 25-yard line. From the 25-yard line, it's first down. Here's an opening. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
Quick pass. He's knocked out of bounds at the 14. So they'll get the first down there on the 5-yard completion.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump off pass that was good enough for a first down.
And he's tackled around the 5-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. And he throws it away. And this play is number 8 on the drive. He dives and he'll be marked down. First down. They've got the defense on their heels now. It's first and goal. And he's got the touchdown. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 21. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Steps out of bounds around the 23-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on their own 23. That pass play gets him roughly 3 yards.
Usually you get a linebacker covering the tight end, so they might want to try some longer passes to exploit that mismatch.
Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on their own 26. He scrambled. He's taken down at the 31. A 5-yard quarterback scramble. Burks is the punter. He makes it to the 42-yard line. The Knights offensive staff, I think, has done a good job of keeping their wide receiver in the game. Even though he's not having great stats, he's part of it, and the rest of the team now is picking up his slack, I think.
Well, this offense is still putting points on the board, and I think at times they're actually using the wide receiver, the go-to man who's drawing so much attention, really as a decoy, open up other avenues of this offense. We've seen other receivers make some plays. They're running the football. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments this defense makes to try to slow down these other members of this offense. And who knows, maybe that could open it back up for that marquee receiver.
Brought down at the 49. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out.
Clipping. Offense.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. So it's second down and long now after the penalty. And a quick throw, and he tackles him hard at the 44-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. In the shotgun and five wideouts. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. We've got a change at the quarterback position. You've got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning. You don't need three guesses to figure out what they're going to run right here on fourth and short. He's at the 40. He's pushed out of bounds at the 35-yard line. From the 35-yard line, first down. And down he goes at the 18. The Knights are going to call their second timeout. And he's taken down to the backfield. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed it.
He's out of bounds right around the 12-yard line. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. Feeling this ball is going nowhere near the return man with this kickoff, most likely to end the half. Richardson from the 7. There's a fumble. Picks up the fumble. And he's brought down at the 16-yard line. So at the end of the half, the Knights lead it 17-3.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There's no question you'd rather be up by two scores as opposed to being down by two scores. I mean, David, I totally...
That was an easy answer,
look,
yes.
Look, I totally get that. But I think there is a mindset there that when you have that two-score lead, you're trying to protect something. You don't want to give it up. And if you allow the other team to get close, then things can get tied on you. Can a two-score edge sometimes be a little bit dangerous just in terms of mindset?
I think mindset and also with coaches. A lot of times you see coaches, they get less aggressive. You know, especially on the defensive side of the football, when you get up two scores and you had so much success blitzing the first half and applying pressure, now you're not as comfortable leaving out guys on an island playing man-to-man. They play, yeah. So I think you got to make sure that you continue to do what you're doing. Don't make those big mistakes, but also don't stray away from the game plan. Right now, what you've implemented has worked. Continue to do it.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, bro. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
But wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. And it's a short kickoff. Breedlove fields it at the 22. They'll bring him down at the 32. The Knights continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Slings it.
It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. Gets out to about the 35-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
There's the junior cornerback making a very solid stop. Anytime your corners can contribute like that against the run, it gives your defense another advantage.
It's third and 7. Ball on their own 35. Pulls it in, and that's a first down. He's tackled at about the 49.
That's the kind of rangy flanker every quarterback wants to be throwing to. He did well to make sure he had enough yardage to pick up the first down.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down at the 47. Second and 7. From the 47-yard line, it's second down. Nice run, and he's brought down. Perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. Booming kick. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Tackle made at the 32-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 32. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Goes quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
Number 86 is the intended
receiver. It's third and 5. Ball on their own 37. And they make the stop at about the 45.
Number 2 with the tactical. First down.
the 40.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 40. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and 6.
Intercepted there.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
Here's the 8th play of the series. They bring the quarterback down.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
Fourth and long here after the sack. He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. He fields the punt at the 13. He's taken down at the 15. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Decides to slide.
The quarterback thought he saw a little bit of running room, but he made a good decision to get down in a hurry.
From their own 17-yard line, second down. Quick throw. Tackle right around the 20.
Number 8 on the tackle at the 20-yard line. Third down.
Third and 5 coming up. Ball on their own 20. Taken down at about the 31. And he throws it away. It's second and 10. Ball on the 31. He's to the 40. He makes his way to about the 42. This is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. The Knights lead it by 2 touchdowns. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. Moves up in the pocket and down he goes.
That'll make it second and 9.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. He's going to try and scramble. And he is drilled at the 35. And this is the 8th play of the drive. out of bounds, right around the 46-yard line. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
He's under some heat. Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way. Breaks a tackle. He's at the 20. To the 10. Touchdown. Huge play. And he converts the extra point. This one away. Breedlove has it at the 5, brought down at the 19-yard line.
The Knights have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
It's going to be interesting now to see if this quarterback can put that last throw behind him.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off the mistakes.
That'll make it second and 7.
It's second and 7. Ball on their own 22. Makes the catch and look out, and he's tackled at the 34-yard line. And he's knocked out immediately after the catch. Taken down
at about the 39-yard line.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. Just under 3 to go in regulation. It's complete. And they finally knock him out at the 14-yard line.
It's going to be tough for this team, obviously, to get back into this football game. But I just love to see the pride they're playing. They are determined to play until the final whistle, and they're not giving up. You hear that, kids? They're not giving up, and that's a key.
Rifles it left. And this play is number 8 on the drive. And he hits him hard at the 3-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Tackles him hard at the 1-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That brings him second and
10th play of the drive.
Tight end right. Tight end right. I got you pumped. Check over there. Check. Easy, easy.
And they got him.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
It's third down. They need 8 yards here to get the ball in the end zone. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. The D sniffs out the screen pass and holds him to a short game.
Contain, contain, contain. That's the only way you can shut down a guy with 4-2 speed.
Just under 2 to go in the game. That's a great tackle at the 9.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
A conversion there could have really helped them, but it just wasn't to be. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. And down he goes at about the 11. From their own 11-yard line. Second down. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it 3rd and 1.
Run up the middle.
Gaining 4 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
Down. Watch two.
The Knights coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.